Hi friends, hope you all are doing well. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Shawn Voskis, and today I'm going to be talking to you about how and what I pack for a camping music festival. We are leaving in just 8 short days to attend Imagine Music Festival in Chattahoochee Hills outside of Atlanta, Georgia, and we're going to be camping for 4 days and 4 nights while attending the music festival. So in order for us to have a fun, safe, and successful trip, a lot of planning happens in the months before the festival. I'm not gonna have time in this short video to go over the entire planning process, so I'm just going to focus on packing itself. Now, I'm not actually done packing for this festival yet. I'm still like midway through the process, but I wanted to make sure to get this video out there because I know a lot of other people are preparing for this festival along with us, and I thought that you all might find it helpful. We are very experienced campers and festival attendees, so a lot of practice has also gone into this, but I'm going to focus on 3 main aspects in this video: list making, how I actually pack, like what containers and things I actually put everything into and how I keep it all organized, and then some of the must-have items that I think are really important for you to bring with you. With all that being said, let's just go right ahead and get on into it. So most importantly, the very first step, the list. Honestly, there's like 4 different lists, like a packing list, a shopping list, a grocery list, a list of lists. But just focusing again on the packing itself, I like to start this list as early as possible. You really cannot start it soon enough, but at least a month before you're going to leave, you're going to want to start working on your packing list. This will give you a lot of time to continue to add things as the weeks go by and as you think of them and they come up and, you know, kind of pop into your brain. If you try to make your list at the very last minute, I guarantee you, you're going to forget something. I have personally been working on our list, our packing list, for probably 3 months at this point, and I have condensed it several times. I may post our full list in the description of this video down below, but like I said, at the end of the video, I'm going to go over some of the must-have items off of that list. Also, with my list, I like to categorize everything, and that way I make it even easier not to forget. So I'll do like kitchen supplies, bathroom supplies, clothing, makeup, jewelry, camping supplies and camping gear, etc. And that way I can just organize my thoughts a little bit easier as I'm making the list itself. Okay, so the second step is to buy anything that you don't already have. And especially if you're gonna be ordering those things online, you wanna make sure to do it well in advance in case there are any shipping delays, and that way you can make sure you get everything on time and delivered to your door. For festivals especially, I like to buy cute little outfits and things like that, and a lot of those things come from overseas and take a really long time to ship, so you wanna make sure you get those orders in as soon as possible. But of course, I do like to thrift as much as I possibly can, which puts less strain on my pocketbook and on the environment. And this is about the time when our dining room table becomes command central. As things start coming in the mail and we start buying them, we just start putting everything here in the dining room. And this space becomes pretty much useless for anything other than festival packing and planning at this point. And so the packing begins. It all happens right here in the dining room at this table. I try to keep everything as organized as I possibly can, and I sort it all out into different categories on the table here. But as, like I said, as new things come into the house, they all just go here, and then I'll slowly start gathering other items off the list and placing them here as well in the week or so prior to the event. So my favorite thing to pack everything into are these canvas like grocery bags. And I have about 1 million of them. I like them because they always have a flat bottom in them. You can put a lot of things in there and keep it really organized because you can easily see everything that's in there. I also have some like bigger kind of mesh bags, like a beach bag here with lots of different pockets. So anything that helps me to keep everything really easily accessible and organized is how I like to go. A huge no-no, or something I like to avoid, are using plastic grocery bags to pack anything into. They rip and tear too easily. You can never see what's inside of them, and it just always ends in disaster. We also have several of these 3-drawer sets where we are keeping our clothing items and some other things that are smaller that I want to be able to keep organized and have easy access to. for this festival, it does have a reputation for theft. So we are planning to keep everything in the car, and this is going to help us keep it nice and neat. And it's also going to be helpful to have everything in the car because the tent will have more room in it and we'll get more breeze and airflow coming through there. But yeah, these are great just for keeping all of your clothes and stuff in because it's so easy to get everything out and not make a huge mess every day when you're getting dressed, having to dig through a bag or something like that. And I also have a stash of like some smaller cardboard boxes and stuff that I'm going to use to organize some things down in the floorboard of the car once we pack the car up the night before we go. The key really is to keep everything categorized and organized within the bags that you're packing it into. So have like a kitchen bag, a bathroom bag, a makeup bag, and so on. Another thing I really love is to organize things into these small, like little cloth bags with different patterns and designs on them. That way, if I'm sending somebody else to grab something for me out of the tent or the car, I can just be like, grab the butterfly bag or the lighthouse bag, and it's really easy to find what you're looking for. You can see here, I have like all of my jewelry in this one bag. This is my makeup bag here. So it keeps everything condensed and again, just really organized, easy to find. And while you're actually there, you want to make sure that if you're taking something out of a bag, you're pretty much immediately putting it right back into that bag as soon as you're done with it. As soon as you start leaving things laying around, they're going to end up in the wrong bag or not in a bag at all, and then it's going to be impossible to find later on. So now moving on to the must-have items in no particular order, just however I think of them and grab them off the table. But these are all things that I strongly recommend having with you anytime you're camping at a music festival. So first is this camp shower. This one has actually two battery supplies and they're rechargeable by USB. And they go along with this bucket here. So you fill the 5-gallon bucket with water. We always like to get it a little early and leave it out in the sun so it warms up just a little bit. Although a nice cool shower can be nice at a festival when you're sweaty and hot. But camp shower, very, very important. Helps wake you up in the morning and of course gets all that dirt and grime off, and then you're not left waiting in line for festival showers, which can sometimes not be super clean. And along with the camp shower, I have this like plastic, it's kind of like a memory foam mat actually, but this is going to go in the little shower privy tent that we have and down on the ground so that you're not standing in the mud while you're taking your shower. So very important item that I definitely recommend having as a part of your shower setup. Okay, sunscreen and bug spray. This is one of my favorite all natural bug sprays. It's called Swamp Gator. It has no chemicals in it. I normally do make my own with essential oils, but we are not allowed to bring any glass into this festival. And so essential oils do need to be in glass bottles. So I'm bringing this as an alternative, but yeah, plenty of sunscreen. Next, these little mini packages of tissues are imperative for, especially for women. They run out of toilet paper in the porta potties pretty much instantly. So keeping a package of these in your Camelback is going to assure you that you do not end up in a porta potty without any toilet paper. And beneath those, we have some wet wipes. My husband got these. I do have some plant-based ones that I've got in my pack as well. But these are really, really good for keeping your hands clean or just like wiping the seat of the porta potty before you use it and any other kind of yuck and germs that you run into. And then baby wipes are really great to give yourself a good wipe down, especially your feet before you get into your tent at night because they tend to get really dusty and dirty at music festivals walking on dirt paths. But yeah, various uses for the baby wipes, keeping things clean, keeping yourself clean, definitely a must have. Another thing is this damp rid. We have two of them. These are going to go inside of our tent, especially in Georgia in the still basically summertime. This is going to help keep moisture out of the tent and keep mildew from getting in there and stinking and just being yucky. So definitely get some damp rid and just keep them in the corners of your tent. Two is usually plenty for like an 8-person tent. So next is a Camelback or a hydration pack. This is the water bladder. You're definitely going to want one of these at a music festival. You do not want to be paying $4 or $5 or $6 or $8 per bottle of water. Besides, plastic bottles of water are terrible for the environment and terrible for your health. So keep one of these hydration packs on you at all times inside the festival. Also allows you to just carry so much stuff. I've already got mine pretty much packed. I have a pashmina, another must-have item. This is great for covering your shoulders from the sun. It's great if you get a little chilly. You can also sit on it and use it as like a little beach blanket type thing. I've got my hand sanitizer here, which I have refills for, sunglasses, plenty of bandanas to keep the sweat off of my neck and face and body, but also to use as a mask and to keep the dust out of my lungs. This, a friend made for us. This thing is absolutely 100% clutch. It's a fan. And when you are in a crowd and you are getting sweaty and hot, this thing is incredible. It's also a really nice way to make connections with the people that are in the crowd with you, because if you fan somebody, they are going to be a friend for life. Also in here, I have a frog tog type towel. This is a cooling towel. Definitely recommend if you're going to a fest in the South in the summertime. You just get it wet, put it around your neck, keeps you nice and cool. Another thing I recommend are noise reducing earplugs. These are Surefire brand and they come with this cool little package and a little thing to keep them connected around your neck. But these are great when you're up close and you're in the crowd and it's really freaking loud and it can be very damaging to your hearing. And so I definitely recommend having a pair of these. Also in here, like I said, I've got some more wipes, some sanitizer wipes, and the tissues that I already mentioned, which are so, so, so freaking important. They're worth talking about twice. Band-Aids, super important, obviously for the typical first aid reasons, but also to put on toes and ankles and the back of your heel in case you get a blister from walking so much at the festival. So I always keep at least a couple of these in my Camelback as well as back at camp. The last thing in my Camelback that I want to mention is just this Blistex lip balm, because it, again, you're going to be in the sun a lot, your lips get dried out a lot of chapped lips can happen, and this stuff is absolutely fantastic. It's medicated and I love it, and I don't go anywhere without it, especially not to a music festival. Another super important must-have item is candy or something to give away, because it is such a big part of the festival culture to just gift give and share with each other. So we have slowly been making a lot of this, these little bracelets and necklaces, and my son has even helped make some of them over the past few weeks and months. And we have some stickers and some other goodies to give away as well. Also, a towel is really important if you're going to be taking showers. We have these special camp towels made out of microfiber, and they roll up really small and tight and nice, and they even come in this little waterproof bag. So this is the brand of those, and I highly recommend them. They have been great. They dry super, super fast as well. This is like a little handheld water bottle with a fan on it, battery operated. Definitely a must in the summer heat. Again, we're going to be just outside Atlanta, so I do not want to be sweating to death. Extra batteries are something you do not want to forget to bring for this as well. Now, along with your typical glow sticks and glow bracelets and things like that, I love these LED light up flower crowns. They're just super cute to add to any outfit. I always bring enough to give to my girlfriends or any like camping neighbors that we might have. But these are fantastic at night to be able to keep track of each other in the crowd, like as you're walking ahead of one another. And they're also great in the porta potty because it helps to light it up so you can see what you're doing hands-free without needing a headlamp or a flashlight or anything like that. So got these on Amazon. I think it was an 8-pack for $8. Cannot beat that deal. Now, as far as like bathroom or medicine type stuff is concerned, I'm having a really hard time because this particular festival is not allowing us to bring in any supplements or vitamins. I guess they're concerned about people disguising drugs as things like that. And we're also not allowed to bring in any glass at all. So for a family who usually uses a lot of essential oils and homeopathic and herbal remedies, all of which come in glass bottles, I had a really hard time packing my first aid and bathroom or medicine bag for this festival, but here's what I have come up with. Okay, so these are just a few of my must-have items. First is a goat's milk soap for showering and washing our bodies. This is, again, something that's safer for the environment than your typical body wash. I don't want to be putting chemicals back into the earth. And I am reusing these shampoo and conditioner bottles, but they do have a plant-based shampoo and conditioner in them from Young Living, which makes me feel better about using, again, for the earth. I normally use an aerosol saline nasal spray to keep my nose clear of all the dust and to prevent getting sick, but since we can't bring aerosol, I've got this X-Clear, which is, again, a natural nasal spray.
This is really great. It's a chafing ointment. It's called Salty Britches. Again, it's all natural ingredients, and it's really great if you have any chafing from sweating and walking long, long times. I've got some tea, this Echinacea Plus and Throat Coat, which are just herbal teas, which are really helpful for our immune system. I do have some Emergen-C, which I'm not a big fan of because it's not super bioavailable, but since I can't bring my normal supplements, this will have to suffice. I do have some basic homeopathics here. Arnica Montana is great for pain, muscle cramping, bruising, stuff like that. I've got one for fevers and one for throat pain. I've also got this ACE bandage. You just never know if there's any kind of injury, you want to be prepared. And on that same note, I have some lidocaine pain relieving cream that's great if you have like a sprained ankle or any bumps and bruises. This is a unscented African shea butter that I can just use as a moisturizer if I get dry skin. And then last but not least, some after sun aloe gel in case we get any sunburns. So these are the most important like medicinal / bathroom items that I think everyone should have. I would have more things and a different variety of things if I was allowed to bring glass or my typical supplements in, but we're working on what we got here. And I forgot to mention two really important things in the bathroom bag. This is a tin of a healing salve that I make with coconut oil, beeswax, tea tree, and lavender, and some calendula oil. And I just, like I said, I call it a healing salve. It's great for bites, scrapes, cuts, burns, anything skin related. This is a must have. So I'm bringing a little tin of that with me. And then just this empty syringe. One time we had a friend who actually got some metal shavings in his eye while we were camping. He was using a saw and he had to squirt some water in his eye in order to get that out. And I have never gone camping since without an empty syringe, just in case somebody gets something in their eye. It's really small and easy to pack. And you don't want something stuck in your eye all weekend. Obviously these LED light up bubble guns are an absolute must have, and they come with a little bottle of bubbles that screws onto here, but beware because the bubbles that come with them are usually complete crap, so you're going to want to invest in some higher quality bubble solution. But we got this pack on Amazon and it came with 3 guns, and all of the batteries are actually already included, so that was a good deal. Another thing I really love are these masks that I bought. They're just a little bit more decorative than the typical masks that we usually wear, and I think they're going to match my outfits really good. They got these little sequins on them. I got it in black and then this like shiny silverish blue color, and they do come with these filters and they go inside of the little pocket here. I love this material on the inside. It's really soft and comfy, and then they have the adjustable ear straps also. And then this is an item you absolutely cannot festival without. It is biodegradable body glitter. Really important to get the earth-friendly biodegradable kind because glitter is just absolutely terrible for the environment. But this comes with a bunch of different colors and shapes, little moons and hearts. There's like little unicorn, silver unicorn ones. There's a multicolored glitter in here. And then I just apply it to my face and my body with eyelash glue. This is a giant spider web, and I know it seems really strange, but it's super fun to get one of these out at the front of the stage in a big crowd and just start spreading it out and passing it on to people. And eventually, before you know it, there's like 100 people inside the web, and it's a lot of fun. It gets everybody kind of working together and involved, and people just really love it.
Okay, so the rest of the stuff I want to talk about is actual camping gear, which we keep outside in outside storage, so I don't have it on hand. I'll probably just pop a picture or a little video clip of each thing up here on the screen as I'm talking about it. I already did mention the privy tent, which is what we use for our shower to go in, and it's just a really small little tent. You can buy them really cheap on Amazon or at most camping stores like Academy Sports, and it's a great place to just get dressed. You can also put your camp potty in there, potty bucket. I have a 5-year-old, sorry for the use of the word potty. But you can buy the potty bucket is definitely a must have for anybody who gets up to pee like 7 times in the middle of the night like I do. You don't want to be trudging through the mud and the muck and through other people's campsites at all hours of the morning and night just to pee. So having the potty bucket is super helpful. They can be found online and at most camp stores and stuff like that, but it's basically just a 5-gallon bucket with a little seat on it. And then what we do is we put kitty litter, so we put a plastic bag down in it and just a little layer of kitty litter down in there. We only use this for peeing, okay? I'm not ashamed to say that I get up and pee like 77 times in the middle of the night, and I will not go camping without the potty bucket. So just remember to bring bags and kitty litter with that as well. Okay, so talking about the tent itself and what you're going to be sleeping in, I strongly, strongly, strongly recommend for a music festival to have a dark rest or blackout tent. Ours is Ozark Trail brand. We got it from Walmart. I think it was like $120, and we have gotten so much use out of it. It is fantastic for festivals because normally you're not going to bed until like 3 o'clock in the morning. And that means that you're sleeping well past sunrise and you want it to stay nice and dark in the tent so you don't get woken up by the daylight. Also, it does keep it cooler in there, and most of them have these like ventilation areas down low, and a lot of breeze comes flowing through really nicely in those blackout tents. Ours is extra cool because it has a set of LED lights all the way through the top, and those are battery operated and they light up the whole tent, and it's really great when you're in there getting dressed at night and things like that. Along with your tent, you want to have a tarp underneath your tent that is tucked in under the edges of the tent all the way without any of the tarp showing. This is to keep your tent bottom from getting wet and saturated with water if and when it rains. If the edges of the tarp are sticking out, the rainwater is just going to pool up underneath it and it's totally useless. You want to have this as a barrier so that the inside of your tent doesn't get soaking wet, your mattress, your blankets, etc. Please, please, please bring a tarp and put it underneath your tent with the edges tucked in. To go along with that, having a canopy over top of your tent is very, very helpful if it's going to rain. Most tents, the rain fly is not going to be very helpful in any kind of heavy rain. Unless you have a very expensive backpacking tent that is already waterproof, you need to have a canopy over your tent as well. This is going to serve to keep the rain off of your tent and to keep water out of your tent, but it's also going to help keep the sunlight off of your tent and keep it a lot cooler in there. We do not camp anywhere ever without a canopy over our tent. And while we're speaking about canopies, for this particular festival, we also have this really great large communal canopy with the walls on it and the windows that you can see through. And this is going to be, like I said, our communal space. We're going to put some rugs down in here while I'm mentioning it. Rugs, super important to have. Little small ones for inside your tent that you can wipe your feet off of before you get into bed. And it just keeps all the dirt like in one area and out of the rest of your tent as you're walking around. But also having a rug inside of this communal tent, it just makes it feel really homey and nice. A lot of people set up super cool like home base campsites where they have the rugs and inflatable couches and stuff like that. So it just makes it feel really cozy and comfy when you come back to camp and you're exhausted and you have this nice place to sit and relax. A jump box. Super important if you want to recharge your phones or if you have anything that you want to run like a sound machine at night. The jump box is also helpful to blow up your air mattress and be able to plug it in. So, you know, the pump for your air mattress, or if you have a kind like we do that just plugs directly in and it inflates itself. So jump box or battery box is a must. And also having extra portable battery banks that you can just plug your phone directly into. If you're like me and you're gonna be vlogging a lot of the experience, your phone battery is gonna die really quickly. So having an extra battery bank in your Camelback as backup is really helpful as well. Another thing that's really helpful to have at camp is a flag or some kind of marker to identify your camp when you're coming back at night or in the middle of the day, because it's all just a giant field of tents at most festivals and it's really hard to find your campsite. So having a flag or something to mark your space that's lifted up high so you can see it is really great. We have our flag on this telescoping little handheld flag pole that we can actually bring it into the festival with us and use it as a totem as well, which is really nice to have if you ever separate and you want to meet back up with your group of friends at a certain set or something like that. You can just put the flag up into the air and wave it around, and that way anyone coming from around you will be able to see you and find you very easily. I personally really love using this type of flag as a totem because a lot of people have really mixed feelings about totems at festivals. They think that they're really big and bulky and they get in the way of people being able to see the set and things like that. So we mostly just like to have it as a way to meet back up with each other if we separate for any reason. And this flag is perfect because when you're done using it to meet up with each other and waving it in the air, you can just wrap it back up and fit it nice into your camelback. On top of the handheld misting fan that I showed you, we also bring some smaller portable fans for inside the tent to keep airflow going in case it gets really hot at night. And make sure to bring extra batteries for those if they are not rechargeable fans. Now, we're not gonna be doing a lot of cooking at this particular festival. We plan to eat from the food vendors. We know that 2020 and 2021 have been really hard years on all of the people that work in this community, and we wanna support those vendors as much as we possibly can. But we are going to be going to another festival next month, and we're bringing our 5-year-old son with us. So we will be doing some camp cooking at that festival. And I may do another video at that point showing you guys some of the kitchen gear that we bring. On top of the camelback for hydration, I also recommend a good thermos or reusable cup to have at camp. Again, it just reduces your waste. Don't bring all those plastic water bottles. They're just toxic for your body and for the environment. Bring yourself a nice metal reusable cup or thermos or something to drink out of at camp. And while we're talking about waste, do not forget to bring plenty of trash bags so that you can make sure you keep your camp nice and clean and get rid of all your waste and put it in the dumpster on your way out and do not leave any trace behind. We cannot continue to have these events that have such a large footprint as it is if we do not take an extra effort to make sure that we leave no garbage and no waste behind. Okay guys, I think that's all I've got. Make your list early, keep everything super organized, and then of course all of the must-have items that I listed. On top of that, make sure to be safe and take care of the earth while you are at the festival. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I am so grateful for each and every one of you watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And as always, make sure to do something to take care of yourselves. Bye. Would you stay till the morning light? Or would you follow me? Or would you let it be if I leave tonight? We could do this right. We'll find the remedy. Or would you stay with me now till the morning light?